In this tutorial, I will show how to roll balls of yarn just by using your hand. When my yarn starts looking like this, it's about time to roll it into a ball. It becomes unmanageable and a little bit harder to work with. It may tend to get knots. And so I've wound the end of it up here. And now we're to this, which is pulling out of the center. You can see it starts to turn into a little bit of a mess here. So at this time, it would be easier to roll it into a ball. And so before I get too big of a knot, what I'm going to do, this is how I do it. I just use my hand. I just start by wrapping it around like this, and I do it several times, just fast like that. I need to make sure that this doesn't turn into a knot. And just continue wrapping. And you do have to contend with these little messes from time to time. I'm sure a lot of you know and have had experience with this little mess. Now I'm going to take it off and I'm going to crisscross it in this direction. And I'm going around like this, and I'm just crossing over the part that I just made with my hand like this. Now I'm going around in this direction. Now I will twist it a little bit like this and go around in this direction. And then I'm consistently moving it around, and then I start to form a ball. And this is how I would make the little tiny balls. Say I have a little bit of yarn left over. Then I just roll them up like this. I have never bought a machine or anything. I have always rolled them up like this. Then I just keep rolling and rolling. And I'm moving it around so the yarn is not in the same place. So you can see I'm just moving it with my fingers. I'm moving it in this direction. But when I go fast like this, I just keep moving it fast. It creates a nice even ball. And then sometimes I'll move it like this just to keep the ball moving, keeping the thread dispersed evenly. And I'll slow down again and you can see how I'm moving the ball towards my hand. Going in this direction. This is how I'm moving it. I'm using this finger. You can see right here. I'm spinning it on my finger like that and just using my hand to create the ball. And then I may want to cover that part up and I'll start a new place and spin it around for a while in this direction. And then I'll move it in this direction. This is how much I have left. I do have quite a bit of winding to do before it's complete. So I will go on ahead and finish winding the ball, and when I come back, it will be a little bit larger than what it is right now. Now I'm almost finished here winding up my ball. Got a little bit here to go. You'll want to be careful and keep this spread out, or you may end up with a knot. This is one of the places where it can knot up pretty easy at any time. And now I'm just about done here. And this is what I have. Nice ball. And the thread is evenly dispersed. Then I can add that to my other balls. And this one blends in. But you can see it's still a very large yarn ball.